What's up? What do you need?
That container, it's gone. It's already been unloaded. But the ports say they use some kind of a security algorithm.
Yeah. Yeah, it analyzes a probability matrix for high risk or dangerous cargo, ranks containers according to threat potential.
All right, good. You know about it.
I was on the team that designed it.
No way.
You want to know if you can use the algorithm, work backwards to find this container?
Yeah, I mean, we got 15 girls. They're going out into the workforce, and I mean, they might have this deadly virus, so I don't know what else to do.
You realize the initial rate of transmission for a disease like influenza amongst prostitutes?
Yeah, look, I mean, even I can do that math, so let me know what you get, all right? And don't worry, you're going to be all right. It'll be fine.
So the port security algorithm analyzes potential terrorist threats. However, it misses things like drugs, contraband, even human cargo.
So we could potentially stop a dirty bomb, but a pandemic flu is in like Flint?
Not anymore. Not anymore if this works.
I love this part.
So the security algorithm uses inputs like point of origin, the company shipping the goods, the volume and type of cargo. It highlights trouble areas. Think of a dandelion. The ones you used to blow into the wind when you were a kid. The algorithm evaluates the threat potential of each seed. Harmless seeds are released, bad seeds are identified and contained.
So if we change the inputs, we can track different seeds.
Exactly. And I use Susan Lim's research to create a whole new set of input variables.
So you found the container?
Containers, plural.
There's more than one?
No, but there are limits to how precise the algorithm can be. I ran it against the cargo manifest of the LiPo, and I narrowed it down to four possibilities. One of the import companies on this list has your container.